Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you're going to learn about the Google Ads reporting options available in Google Analytics. We'll walk through the steps to report on your campaigns using the standard pre-configured reports and how you can create custom exploration reports to see the performance of Google Ads inside Google Analytics. Before we jump into the reports, I'm going to briefly cover how to link your Google Ads account to Google Analytics. If you're not seeing data for your campaigns in Google Analytics, then these are the steps you'll need to follow. Okay, let's head to Google Analytics. I've already opened my Google Analytics demo property, and we're looking at the admin area. To link Google Ads, we can select Google Ads links, or select product links on the left and choose Google Ads links. Then we click link and select choose Google Ads accounts. Now we can select the account or accounts we want to link. Then we click confirm and we click next. I'm going to leave the default settings so that audiences from Google Analytics are automatically published to my Google Ads account. I'm going to leave the default settings for auto tagging. This will automatically pull data into our reports. And I'm going to allow Google Ads users to access Google Analytics features. Then we need to click Next. We can double check the selections we've made and then click Submit. We can now see that the Google Ads account is linked to Google Analytics. Moving forward, data will begin to show up in our reports. Apart from linking accounts, if you want to create audience lists in Google Ads for remarketing, you'll also need to activate Google Signals. To do this, we need to select Data Collection and Modification on the left, and then select Data Collection. We can then turn on Google Signals if it's not already enabled. Okay, now that we've linked Google Ads to Google Analytics, we're going to take a look at how we can report on the performance of our campaigns. Remember, you will need to wait up to 24 hours until you see Google Ads data in Google Analytics. This is because data will only flow into your reports once your accounts are linked. Since we've only just linked our Google Ads account, we're going to use Google's demo property to take a look at the reports. So let's open Google's demo. And let's navigate to Reports. We're looking at the report snapshot. This report provides a quick summary of your website. I'm not going to spend too much time on this report, but scrolling down, I did want to highlight that your Google Ads traffic will automatically show up as CPC or cost per click when using the session medium dimension. So whenever you see CPC, this includes your Google Ads traffic, plus any other custom campaigns you're tracking into Google Analytics with a medium of CPC. And when you use the primary channel group dimension, like we can see in the new users by first user primary channel group card, Google Ads traffic can appear as different channels. Google Ads can be included in the paid search, display, cross network, paid video, paid shopping, and paid social channels. Okay, let's head to the acquisition reports. And let's open the overview report. This report shows you all of the different ways people are finding your website. This includes how new users are finding your website, and the ways people are finding your website to initiate a new session. The card that shows Sessions by Session Google Ads campaign shows you all of the campaigns currently driving traffic to your website. Let's click the View Google Ads campaigns link at the bottom of the card. We're now looking at the standard pre-configured Google Ads report. At the top, we can see a chart that will include the most popular campaigns by default. Traveling down, we can see the table. This lists all of the campaigns from the linked Google Ads account or accounts. And we can see a breakdown of metrics for each campaign. This includes the number of active users and sessions, along with additional engagement metrics. And on the right, we can see key events which report on the number of conversions for each campaign and the total revenue. You can also change the dimension used for the report. For example, we can select Session Google Ads Campaign and change this to Session Google Ads Ad Network Type. This lets us report on the types of campaigns we're running in Google Ads. Apart from reporting on Google Ads using the standard report we just looked at, you can also build your own exploration reports. We're going to build a report that combines the keyword that we're bidding on in Google Ads with the search term or query that someone entered on Google. Let's head back to Google Analytics to take a look at how we can do this. Let's navigate to Explore. And let's click blank to create a new report from scratch. Let's name the report Google Ads Keywords and Queries. To start, we need to enable the dimensions and metrics we want to use in the report. So let's start by clicking the plus sign next to Dimensions. And let's search for Keyword. And we need to enable Session Google Ads Keyword Text. Then we need to search for Query. We also need to enable Session Google Ads Query. And if you would like to create a different type of custom report in Google Analytics using data from Google Ads, then searching for Google Ads will show you all of the different dimensions you can choose from. I'm happy with the keyword and query, so let's click Import. Now we need to enable the metrics we want to use in the report. So let's click the plus sign next to Metrics. And let's search for Sessions. Let's enable this metric. Let's also search for key events. And enable this metric too. Now I'm going to click Import, but again, if you want to create a different type of report, you can select additional metrics. Now let's double-click the dimensions to add them under rows. And let's double-click the metrics to add them under values. We've now created a report that shows us the keywords we're bidding on and the queries people are searching for on Google to see our ads. And for each row, we can see the number of sessions, along with any key events to report on conversions. Now that we've covered the standard reports and how to create a custom exploration report, let's take a look at how our Google Ads traffic appears in the advertising reports. Let's head back to Google Analytics. To view the reports, let's navigate to Advertising. These reports let you compare the performance of your Google Ads campaigns to your other marketing channels, and they also include the dedicated attribution reports. The first card shows you the total number of conversions, which is the blue line, along with any conversions from Google Ads, which is the purple line. You can use the selector at the top of the card to choose which conversions are included from your linked Google Ads accounts. And as we can see, Google's demo property has linked with multiple Google Ads accounts, so we can choose the conversions we want to include. Okay, now let's open the Google Ads report under Planning. This report is similar to the standard pre-configured report we looked at earlier because it presents the different Google Ads campaigns by default. However, this report combines metrics from Google Analytics with metrics from Google Ads. Key events and total revenue are from Google Analytics, while ads cost, ads clicks, and ads cost per click are imported directly from Google Ads. And cost per key event and return on ad spend are both calculated using data from both Google Ads and Google Analytics. Like the standard pre-configured report, you can also change the dimension presented using the drop-down. And you can click the plus sign to add a secondary dimension to the report. For example, we can add country to see a breakdown of both the campaign and country in the report. And as we can see, when we add a second dimension to the report, only the Google Analytics data will be available for each row. Finally, let's take a look at advertising segments. This is useful if you're looking to run remarketing campaigns in your linked Google Ads account. It lets you see the audience size for each of your audience lists broken down by the advertising networks available in Google Ads. If you meet the minimum list size, you can then create remarketing campaigns to target your ads to those users in Google Ads. So that's how you can report on your Google Ads campaigns in Google Analytics. Remember that you will need to ensure your accounts are linked. And if you haven't enabled key events to report on conversions, please take a moment to check out my other videos. I've included links in the description. How are you going to report on campaigns using Google Analytics? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.